Is this the right place?
What are we talking about?
Alright, we're done. We're done with this area.
Oh yeah, definitely.
I'm gonna go talk to a bunny. You a forlorn
look. It seems you're gonna go talk to a bunny? To
speak to you, yep.
But can't. Where is said bunny?
Teleport to me.
Oh, right.
And we will bunny conversate. The bunny wants to talk to us. What's the matter, fella? Cat got your tongue?
The rabbit nods and points to the northeast. The cat that got its tongue must have wandered off in that direction.
What? Cat literally got its tongue? By the way, I am styling as fuck in this neon-ass robe. What have you done to me?
You look like you're going around in a bathrobe right, or something. Jeez.
Especially with the two glowing wands that are both the same element behind me.
I love your helmet, though. Your helmet your helmet and Bear Daughter's helmet just make both of you just look like semi-dirty hobos that have managed to get your hands... Actually, all of us look like weird, kind of dirty hobo people.
Yeah, I don't think there's that many alternatives to that.
Gonna be honest, though, my helmet doesn't make me look much better. Can you, like, zoom in and take a look at how my helmet sits on my character's head?
The way that it looks like it's weirdly high compared to
everything
else. Yeah,
it gives him a good, like, 4 inches on top of his head. Which feels really, really wrong.
There's a nice clear line that says cut here. It was a weird choice of tattoo.
Yeah.
Probably should have opted out of that one.
I mean, isometric games, man, they don't need to care. They don't need to bother.
New zone.
New map.
So I took a look at the quest list, not to actually read what the quests were,
hello.
But just to see what the list was.
Hail, Source Hunter.
Arhu.
Good to see you've reached Lakula Forest. There were times when I came to this neck of the woods just to whiff its wholesome air. Alas, that it is thick with sorcery these days.
Sorcery abounds, doesn't it? Oh, right, before we do anything. Before we forget and he leaves, I'm gonna buy all of his,
Resurrection scrolls?
Yeah.
So I took a look at the quest list, not to, like, spoil the quests themselves, but just to see what it was shaped like, and this game is... It's a much larger scale game, obviously, but it has the same thing as Bound by Flame, where every subsequent act out of the 4 acts massively downscales the number of side quests.
Yeah, I'm okay with that, though.
To the point where I think, like, half the game's side quests were actually in the first zone.
Yeah, it speeds things along a little bit.
I think by the time you get to the last zone, there's about as many side quests as there are main quests. So we're actually pretty far along in the old game's overall content, even though we're only 1/4 of the way through the story. Although
I've been looking at it.
The chapters also have more story missions.
Yeah. Let's see. Sorcerer Bounds, does it?
It surrounds us here. Like an invisible mist. Takes cat's eyes to see it creep. Even so, it's plain as day to the east, all about Ikara's cabin. Immaculates beset it, no doubt under Leandra's orders. If she has ordered such thorough defenses of her sister's cabin, we may be certain that whatever lies within will be a prize more precious than butter-baked place. That means Ikara herself must be there, Hunter. And it is essential that you find her. Only she can shed light on the details of Leandra's plans.
I thank you for your counsel. High time to mosey on.
Ha! Zigzags would see you dash rather than mosey. But matters such as these require a thoughtful approach. Leandra and her cronies may be lunatics all, but they're far from brainless. So be wary, Hunter, and be safe.
Well.
All right.
So we've got Witch's Cabin, or let's go north, actually, first, to Silver Glen.
Now I want to look up what a butter-baked place is.
Place is?
Place, I think? Yeah, P-L-A-I-S-E.
P-L-A-I-S-E, I believe. It is a fish. It is a dumb-looking flat fish.
Damn it, it's because he's a fucking cat.
Yeah, you didn't know that?
Forgot about the cat part for a second there.
I forget the whole cat business. Oh,
I wanted into an earth elemental fight and some plants.
Oh.
They're coming for me.
I'm in a conversation.
How are you in a conversation? With what?
There's a dude. Source Hunter.
This game cool, is, this is Silver so awkwardly Glenn. Implemented in a co-op.
For the pursuit of divinity. She showed us how we may overcome, but I suggest you talk to Father...
Okay, he's...
Right, well, this is one of those moments effectively where the co-op falls apart. Immaculates here
seem to be a friendly he's a tour bunch. Guide. You know what? Though surprise! I'm here now.
Hola.
We are...
Estás?
This is... Me llamo... Wanderbot.
What is Earth weak against?
Water. No, that's probably fire. I wouldn't be surprised if... No, air probably doesn't work against him. Fire, maybe. Seeing as there are wooden parts and grassy bits? I don't know.
That's not what Earth... Yeah, I don't know.
Wait, we knew this earlier. Remember with the elementals? It's
yeah,
yeah
we
it's,
did it at some point,
it's fire.
Oh well.
Yeah, because we used the fire against the poison shrine, electricity against the water shrine, water against the... Yeah, it's a square, and they go around...
No, I have
on each other. Yeah,
I have two blitz on my bar. How did I do that? Stakes have been made.
You were just
stakes were made. You know, stakes
were
made.
You were doing things. Shock to the core.
Huh? That did more damage, I think.
Let's see. I can check. Though blitz bolt does more damage because it doesn't have a burning effect.
Bam! That does even more damage, and that was an air-based attack. Oh no, yeah, so I have no idea. Or spell effects. Yep. Oh, there we go. Oh right, that's just a freeze. Whoops. Well, that happened. We're all nicely packed together for a nice AoE attack from the enemy.
That's okay.
What was that guy attacking?
Got
that
covered.
You
don't have a leg to stand on.
Look, poison.
Well...
How'd you get the exploding poison to show up?
I do fire damage.
Oh.
Yeah.
Weird. Where'd the poison come from? Just hitting them?
They're earth. They do poison. God damn.
Alright. That was some damage coming in. You're gonna have a good chapter. You're gonna have a good chapter. So was that guy back there talking about anything important?
No. He was just talking about people that we can, like, interact with in town. You know, I'm just gonna accept the fire damage. Ooh, that was a lot of fire damage.
We're all very proud of you. Oh, he's heading back. He's
yeah,
angry.
There's. So my current amulet makes me explode with fire damage in response.
Oh, there goes my turn. Do some ice for funsies. I conjure the spear. Oh, that didn't do much. Ah, well. I really should have just staffed him. You are very much dying. Did we lose you?
Yeah, just a little bit. Let's see. Sorry.
I'm like, is he gonna hit him with his axe?
I
don't think it's that many decisions.
I did not realize it was my turn in the turn order. You know what? I'm just going to drink a bunch of these. Wow.
Yeah,
that is
one
effective.
One of my two characters should have really healed you. Blood venom charms within me. I guess they'll heal her now because she's dying.
Do they do both? Oh, wait. Because, she is gone.
Wow. Get wrecked, apparently.
Fuck. Yeah, because she was on fire. Because she was on fire, things just get nonsensical. Yeah, I think rain is maybe a good idea.
Yeah, it's probably the thing to do.
A little bit late for me, but still.
A lot of fires happening around here.
I noticed they ramped up the damage pretty heavily between the last area and then this one.
Up.
Oh, because there's ice on the ground. Hammer time.
Oh, I'm so good at doing that. Such a problem. Alright, so this will cost me 5 AP, so I can spend this much getting in range. Fuck. So much for that. I spent my turn tripping. Tripping balls, man. All the balls.
Oh, I see. Wait, out of range. Oh, it's because of that stupid... You serious?
That ice spell was such a bad idea. didn't even accomplish anything damage-wise, and it tripped both my characters.
On the mend!
Okay. I'm glad I've got the morning person perk.
Bear What's the daughter? Morning person okay. perk?
Morning person makes it so, when... that didn't work. Whenever you resurrect a character, they come back at full health.
Oh.
Yeah. Which is really nice.
So does it affect the person being resurrected or the person resurrecting?
Person resurrected.
So Bear Daughter has the perk?
Both of my characters have the perk.
Oh.
Yeah. I figured it made sense, considering how often both of my characters die over yours.
I wonder what it's like to roll with four characters that all have... They all have Geomancy and Zombie and Poison attacks.
It'd be impressive. Oh, Jahan
One day
is...
I'll stand up again.
Jahan wants to talk to us. Oh, I should probably heal.
He's got to stand up for that first.
I should probably heal myself. There's a Poison Cloud if you want to go run around in it.
I'm full health.
Oh, well, never mind. Right, I'm the only one that took damage there because...
Well, besides the dead person.
Well, I mean, I consider both my characters to be extensions. Apparently these plants had eyeballs.
And animal hide.
I guess they probably ate things, but still. Maybe. The amount of loot that we received from that is lackluster. Are you going to talk to Jahan?
Sure.
We're just going to
ignore
him.
Stop moving for a second.
The degenerates here claim they have been cleansed. But I can still smell the stink of persisting putrescence wafting from their grimy flesh. Silver Glen, this place sickens me.
I see no evidence of sickness about me. Why take it to heart so?
I can tell you if you wish, but you'd have to listen to the tale of my life. Because my future, such as it is rooted deeply into my history.
You want to find out why he's a dick?
Or you can just press 4.
Get out of here.
You'd have to learn my tragic backstory. Get the fuck out of here, Jahan. I don't want you anymore. Yeah, I mean, we might as well go. Go with hearing his backstory.
Tell me more about your history, Jahan, if you please.
So I shall.
Why don't you start at the beginning?
Once upon a time,
you really started that way.
In a land of beauty to the east. A land of tigers and slender towers, of deserts and forests, of sun and all the world's wealth. I was a young king, handsome and all-powerful. Every nobleman would have killed his own brother if I promised to take his daughter's hand in marriage. But I refused their incessant implorations. I knew my life as a sovereign would be self-indulgent, but also a self-delusory one, if I weren't to marry for love. And so a handful of years went by. The king's throne I myself occupied, whereas the queen's throne remained empty but for the court's cats that would nap the afternoons away upon its velvet cushions. But then one day, a young woman visited my kingdom. She was a poetess and a storyteller. People flocked to her, listened to her every word as if receiving mantras from the divines. I invited her to my palace, and soon our days, our nights, our love and our lives intertwined.
Tell me more about your lover.
Hiraka. How I miss her still. Miss the brilliance of her mind that was both as sparkling and as unbreakable as the diamonds that adorned her body. Oh, and how I miss her body. 1,000 artists I could have commanded, show me beauty. But she would have effortlessly surpassed their every endeavor, and curving her lips into a smile, make them break their sculptures in tearful impotence. And yet, true happiness, that commodity more precious and even more fleeting than the dominion of kings, sang to us like the nightingale, only to depart come the dawn of our first year's unity. a malady overtook me, and I began to wither.
Tell me about the malady that overtook you.
It was an unparalleled horror. Scores of physicians flocked to my bedside. They traveled from realms across the seas, hoping to cure the mighty Jehan, undo the gloom that had befallen the land, and mere vultures that they were, to be paid handsomely for their efforts. But none of their potions took effect. Their salves seared, but did not soothe my fading flesh. Like a ghoul I looked, unburied yet risen from the grave. In futile anger, I struck my mirror, but broke my brittle fingers only, not its ever-mocking surface.
Then how did you manage to cure yourself?
It went like this, Hunter. If a ghoul I had become, so a dark turn of thought convinced me, a ghoul's methods I should employ to escape the labyrinthian crypt of corporeal corruption. A necromancer I'd be. Yes, only from deep within the deliriums of death would I tunnel my way back into the gardens of life. I did unspeakable things in the dusky dungeons that twist like forgotten veins to long-deceased organs far beneath my castle's sunlit halls. Halls which held my throne and held the bed upon which Heraka slept, her very touch blessing the satin she reposed upon. Still there came no relief. Perversions I created in scores, but they were mere undead all. Creatures so piteous that the thought of cheating death in their guise frightened me more than the swing of the scythe itself. Like mosquitoes in the night, panic and despair beset me until I turned to that darkest of all arts, demonology.
So you, of all people, turned to demonology.
It had to be. There was no other way. I could feel the life slipping out of me like love out of a betrayed spouse's heart. So I studied tomes so old the dust that fell from their centuries' unperused pages never knew the light of the stars that now shine. I drew forbidden symbols. I spoke unhallowed words. And from the smoke that rose like a dragon's last breath, a demon appeared to me and said, "Ask, O blighted king, and you shall have." "Just tell me," I cried. "Tell me what ails me."
And what was his answer?
"Heraka." Never had I known a single word can cut deeper than the sharpest of daggers. With maddening glee, the demon told me she was one of his kin. A soul-swallowing horror that had been feeding on both my body and my spirit like a leech. An ancient being was she, that moved from king to king throughout the ages, filling their hearts with love, then draining them of life. After such revelations, does one truly desire to live on? Death seemed like a mother then, welcoming me with her all-will-be-well embrace. Yet still I feared exceedingly her seemingly sweet caress, and the oblivion that would follow. Release me from her, demon, and give me back the strength of a sick, free existence. So went my desperate plea. It smiled, of course it did. Smiled bare a hundred razors as its eyes came alight with infernal fire. "A thousand years I will give you," it whispered. "But then your soul shall be mine to incarcerate in the depths of hellish nemesis. As for your throne, that I'll have now. What say you, O brittle king? Do you accept my terms?"
Did you accept?
I think you know the answer to that question, Hunter. But I've said enough for now. These memories are painful to recollect. So let us turn to the rest of them later.
Get out of here! I mean, I'll take my leave.
More prey awaits.
He has reason to be biased against demons, then. But also, he's dramatic as fuck and likes similes a lot.
So I'm going to be honest with you. I actually got up during that conversation, got a bowl of M&Ms, and went to the bathroom. Came back, and he wasn't even halfway done yet, and I was like...
Yep, he kept going. Lots of dramatic, like, window dressing for that story going on, with similes and metaphors and dramatic writing, like a... every sophomore that in English class.
Yeah. Well, let's see what our characters have to say about that.
Well, well, well. So our very own demon hunter once dabbled in the so-called darkest of arts himself.
Demon hunter? Imposter, more like. All his talk of demons has been nothing but double-faced falsity.
You hit the nail on the head. No matter the circumstance, I simply cannot abide a hypocrite.
Jahan's just sitting over in the corner being like,
You'll be hearing about this in my poetry.
You find his journal later.
It could be an ambush.
I'm gonna save, by the way.
It could be an ambush. Hey, look, an ambush.
I think we're getting attacked by those butterflies over there. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What the f-
Yes, you are. Why do they have flappy rectangles around them?
You know,
you can see the weird triangles, the weird shapes around them, right?
I can't hit them.
Oh.
Oh, that's why she can't hit them.
Do you have an AoE?
That's why she can't. Okay.
You got blinded or something?
She is directly inside of an enemy.
Oh. Guess hit that.
Take it!
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, that worked.
That arrow took an interesting path. How do you deflect an arrow off a wasp? I don't know
witchcraft,
if I buy that one.
Wizardry and...
No, I'm the witch. You're an archer. I'm the witch.
There we go.
Oh, there's more of them down there.
Yeah, we got a bunch of plants. This place is kind of crazy. Right, you might want to heal Wander, by the way. He is very much hurt.
I'll do that with Jahan.
Yep, sounds fine.
My enemies.
Ground wolf is terrifying.
You know, in retrospect, I think the spider might have been a better move.
Shut up, I got a new summon. I don't need your reasoning. That's not the spell to use on that guy. Are we in range for this on this guy? Oh yeah, we are.
You know, poison is surprisingly ineffective against enemies in this game.
My poison bolt is because really strong.
But there's so many enemies that either are resistant or heal from poison. That's kind of my point. Or explode, get set on fire, and start healing from that fire.
I feel like that's also most elements.
But
I
like
think that's just
water,
the nature of elemental combat in this game.
Water, ice, and electricity all. I mean, I guess water and ice
are
kind of...
We've already encountered enemies that absorb water.
But they're much rarer. That's kind of my point.
Well, yeah, but the game's divided into four acts, where there's going to be different varieties of enemies. For example, the whole point of the last zone is that everyone's a skeleton or a zombie, basically.
This is true.
Now we're fighting plants. And wasps, apparently. Change of pace. I admittedly kind of forgot that the wolf could be poisoned. I'm like, it's an earth summon, he'll be fine. Uh-oh.
Are there two plants over here? Two? No, there's just one.
Now he's
over
bleeding
there.
Out his ears.
I don't think this is going to hit me, but it's totally going to hit me. Excitement!
Probably. After firing this one. How are you feeling?
She did not get hit by that.
Also, when did you type beep boop, motherfucker?
During the very, very long and tragic backstory.
Yeah. Don't forget how tragic it was.
It was super tragic.
Tragic.
Oh, wow, yeah, they... So these guys, do you see these guys in the poison cloud? Oh my god, really?
What?
So these guys aren't 3D models, they're just 2D images.
Are you talking about the wasps?
Yeah, the wasps. Like, I'm looking at them now, they're 2D images, that have been either that or their wings might just be the 2D images. I'm not entirely sure.
Yeah, their bodies are 3D. I can see that from every direction.
Yeah, you're right.
It'll be wrong, Wander.
Well, you know what? I'm looking at them from the back, but their wings are just this transparent PNG that's just being flapped as opposed to like a 3D object. So in any situation where like your vision would be obscured, you get to see the quote-unquote hitbox of this. Wow, that is stupid looking.
Oh yeah, the big square?
Yeah.
That also happens every time they ever get highlighted, the way that we get highlighted with a white outline. They turn into a bunch of floating rectangles.
Wow.
That's what I was commenting on when we first started the fight.
That is so tacky.
I was like, why is there flapping rectangles attacking us?
Yeah, I thought about... There is a lot of poison around here. You know, I might just consider converting all of my people over to zombie at some point.
Yeah. Nullify all of our points into the water school to get those healing spells.
I mean, you like that freezing spell.
Yeah.
I'm not totally sold on the idea, though.
I will say we don't have a lot of poison spells right now.
Yeah.
In fact, I have one poison spell, and that'd be our only... That would become our only healing spell in the party.
This is a good point. She is also dying. Does she have any healing potions? No.
Jahan's turn is soon.
Give me a second. I can figure it out.
And then she can feel all better.
Whether she wants to or not.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, that'd probably be a good thing. She's got 109 health left, but it's still definitely, like... She's dying.
She does have a lot of hit points.
Yeah.
A somewhat surprising number of hit points. Is my character stunned? Why is he laying on the ground?
I don't know, actually.
Oh, my healing's on a cooldown.
Well.
My other character can probably heal when it's his turn.
Yeah, that'll be soon. These two are almost dead anyway.
Oh, I hit that wasp on accident.
I didn't even realize it was still there.
No, I was shooting at plants. I forgot the wasp was standing in front of me.
Well, it's not anymore.
What's interesting is in my UI, the freaking the chat that pops up telling me what's going on in the game appears and then disappears almost immediately without me being able to read it. Your fucking text message you wrote won't go away. It's been on my screen this whole time, but everything else just disappears a moment later. Like, that's a really weird distinction.
Thunder jump.
And he didn't get set on fire. Yeah, why is your character just, like, unhappy right now?
I don't know. Oh, he looks like he's done with that. Hey, he poisoned me. What will I do? Not poisoned. Oh, no, the poisoning failed.
All right, let's see.
Oh, that's why you were quiet for a minute. You started typing. Like, why did he die in the middle of this conversation? Typing.
You don't have
I will never leave you.
Hi! How's
I got
it,
messy.
How's it going?
I mean, I'm not on fire yet. I'm still
Bear Daughter just blew up. I don't know what's going on. Where's the last
a
guy?
Lot
this
of poison
one?
Poison and fire is going on.
There we go. Oh boy.
I'm gonna find my way out of here before Jahan runs into me and directly into the fire. All right, well, my party's completely healthy at the moment. How are you feeling?
it hurts so much.
Hey, we leveled up.
Hey!
Good news.
Let's see. Is there anything that requires a higher strength? I should probably level my strength, come to think of it.
Go a little bit high. I'm going to go more into... Yeah, I'm going to go up to 10 intelligence. Help out. Let's see. Where's my pyrokinetic? There we go. A little deeper into that. Now I should be able to learn that skill book. There we go. Alright.
Oh, the fire elemental wander. One?
Yeah.
Now you have. Ooh, he's big.
Spooky, spooky.
I don't know if spooky or just impressive.
Shut up, spooky. You don't know my life. Now I have four summons. I'm okay with this.
Shame you can't summon them all.
Yeah, just one turn at a time, just spam every single possible summon.
Let's see. Did you want this cloth helmet back or no?
If I threw it at you, then it's probably something that I'm just trying to get rid of.
Okay, that works.
I have been over encumbered in dumb items.
I've got some mail bracers that require strength, and I'm like, should I put
Jahan
more points into
speed,
strength?
Desperately.
No. Let's see.
Should Jahan go further into water or air?
Water or... Both are good. I'd say air for the time being until we get a... Well, no. Just save your points. We don't have any new skill books, so what does it matter?
I think that affects your effectiveness with those schools, too.
No, it doesn't. Somebody left a fairly emphatic thing about it. What does is your... Your intelligence is what determines your effectiveness. And that's it.
Okay.
Yep.
People love when we misinterpret mechanics.
Yeah, they do.
They get real happy with us.
They're very passionate about these things.
A game that's... It itself doesn't want you to take seriously.
Yeah. Alright.
I might just go further into resistances for a little bit.
That's not a bad idea. I'm probably gonna do that. Which one's poison again? It's either that or I could increase my crit rating. Nah. Which one of these is poison? Knockdown, burning, frozen, bleeding, crippled...
The leadership gives bonus initiative and damage to everyone that can see you in your party, and can't we just all have that stat?
Possibly.
It just keeps improving everyone's initiative and damage all around the entire party.
That might not be a bad idea. I think it might be the... One person gives you the I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
I've got willpower, initiative, and damage. Mine gives initiative and damage. What does yours give you? Willpower?
Oh yeah, 5 of each. Initiative and damage.
Weird. So who's got the who's got the 2 leadership? Is it Jahan?
Let me see. I don't think anyone has 2 leadership.
Weird. Okay. Oddly enough...
Does yours say 2? Does yours say ally has leadership 2 or leadership 1 when you click on leadership?
Ally has leadership 1.
Yeah.
Oh, initiative damage. Why does mine give me +1 willpower? Oh, boosted by the obedient trait. That's very confusing.
So you have an obedience skill that makes you more effective from that.
Yeah.
Well, now we have leadership too. So now take a look at it. It should be like even better now.
Oh yeah. Did you increase yours?
Yeah.
Oh, but since you've got leadership 2, we don't get the benefit from it.
Who doesn't get the benefit from it?
Apparently you don't, if you check your own buff.
Oh yeah, it's for allies.
That's dumb. Alright, I guess...
leadership is.
I guess you and I should just, arms race leadership all the way up, because that's actually really good.
Yeah, 5 initiative, 10% chance to hit, 5% damage at the moment.
Alright, I've got leadership 3 now.
Jesus Christ. Now it's crit chance +3%. It just keeps adding a new thing to the bottom.
Okay. Let's try and stack as much leadership as we can on my character or other people.
Wow. Okay. That'll be a series of buffs.
Yeah. I like it. I don't mind kind of just bringing that one up as we go.
Yeah. All
right.
So we're coming up on some kind of town. Oh, that's Silver Glen.
Yeah. I wanted to go to Silver Glen anyway. We might as well do some, like, shopping. Let's see. Yeah, let's just go in. Let's see what we can find. Side quests and whatnot.
And then summon a fire element in the middle of town. Glen, home and
hearth of Immaculate. Oh, right. The people here are crazy. I forgot about that bit. They're like, they're not cultists, but they're like...
But they're cultists.
Yeah.
That,
this building concerns me.
Over here, Hunter. It's me, Ahu.
Ahu wants to talk to us
clever,
again.
And your clever white cat
Source
disguise.
Hunter, you've made it into the hamlet of Silver.
Oh wait, wrong character. My bad.
Unnerving spot, don't you find? Leandra has fashioned herself a hero here, but the townsfolk don't seem to know the truth behind the conduit, though they call themselves immaculates.
What do you make of these immaculates?
They're thick as trout, if you ask me, and unnaturally obsessed with ancient teachings. I haven't seen Leandra here myself, but she must have put on quite a show of magical mastery to enthrall a crowd of shaggy miners. To have them hop on the bandwagon of a shadowy religion wholly alien to them.
Which ancient teachings do you mean?
Haven't you heard them whisper of the blood? How their eyes shine when they discuss certain stellar stones? Star stones, of course, which drenched in blood become bloodstones and are used in healing rituals. Now, I can see how it could be a fantastic thing to nurse a dying human back to health if all it takes is to sacrifice a toad. But I spy bloodlust in these people's eyes. A bloodlust that goes beyond the usual meaning of the word. They all act like they're following a benign goddess that will lead them to paradise. But I'll be a dappled Dalmatian if any of that is true.
Since you've been scouting the place, perhaps you can tell me where I should start looking for shading goings-on.
I've been shadowing the local priest, a man by the name of Loic. I have the feeling he knows more than most in Silver Glen, for I've followed him in the night when he meets with cloaked strangers, and goblins even. Mangoth? Hyberheim? Of strange things I've heard him whisper. Yes, this priest has shady goings-on written all over that smug, holier-than-thou face of his. But we must start at the beginning, Source Hunter. The White Witch is still at large. If we want to get to the true heart of Leandra's doings, we must start with her sister. And she's far likelier to be in her cabin among the trees than here among Leandra's followers.
So why are you walking around Silverglen in your cat form?
The advantage of being a puss, my friend, is that one can pussyfoot. A white-haired wizard draws attention, but a cat can move about unnoticed and, indeed, unseen. Not that I'm not extra wary of these bloodsuckers, though. There's a conspicuous absence of pets in this eerie little town.
I'll take my leave.
The Immaculate's presence here is highly disconcerting. But we mustn't lose sight of our mission, Source Hunter. The White Witch resides somewhere in the wilds of the surrounding forest, and we must find her.
So Keith, I've got an alternate plan here.
What's that?
How about we kill literally everyone?
No. They have to give us a reason first.
Well, they're crazy cultists that sacrifice people for blood.
Yeah, let's go find them sacrificing someone and then blow up the sacrifice. Altar,
oh,
I mean.
This guy's a shopkeeper.
Hello and welcome to
Maybe
our
he's
shop.
Cool.
I am the son of the proprietor, Nadia. Please
nope.
Let us know how we can
oh, wait.
Help you.
He sells armor scraps. This guy's good for what I do. Actually, don't... Yeah. I'll buy all those lockpicks. I don't know if they're actually useful or not. Okay. Luckily, I have a ton of money. Let's see. So, Nadia is the... actual...
Hunter in Silver Glen.
Like, nice to do business with you. Now die.
To find help. And now help has... how you say...
Are you just shopping or trying to talk about them with stuff?
I'm just shopping. I want to see if there's any particularly powerful gear or equipment.
Quest log. Wow. We still have like 15 quests open right now.
Yeah, I mean, does that really surprise you? Because it probably shouldn't.
Lot to look through.
Yeah. My chat is now accusing me of having a lot of bloodlust. I mean...
It is your go-to.
It does kind of... It does kind of simplify things, just killing everybody.
They do not want me to open that door.
Holy crap, this is a hell of a lot better.
There's a bodyguard over here. He's level 10. Probably auto scales with us. I bet you can hire him as a melee character if you need him.
Good work. Ooh, hey, I got a helmet of the master for more leadership.
Smithy down here.
Oh, you mean this isn't the smithy? I guess that probably would make sense.
Leather ring armor plus one initiative if you have dexterity 7.
I can do my shopping.
Oh no, I'm talking about loot.
Oh, I see.
I'm in stuff the smithy that you have. Built the actual smithy that these guys have, where they do smithing.
Yeah. Okay.
Now I'm sneaking into their back room.
Of course you would. Let's see.
Wouldn't you?
I mean... Yeah, probably. Alright, so... Bear Daughter can now use Boulder Bash. Cool.
Boulder Bash?
Yeah. It's a novice geomancer spell. It causes a boulder to come crashing down from the sky, does 60 to 66 earth damage, and creates an oil surface where it lands.
I found the cellar key for this room if you want to come check that out.
Alright, sounds good to me.
And riveted scale armor, 64 armor rating for strength 7.
There's no reason why I can't just open this door. Hello.
Nope, I already came in. We're good. I have the key to this place.
Sounds good.
Now we're in a cellar.
Oh wait, I just looted a shield through the wall.
Ooh. There's a blank skill book for Earth.
Telekinesis is super broken. Oh hey,
who in the party uses blank books?
I do.
The Wander?
Yeah, Wander uses blank books because I can combine blank books
Sword
with scrolls.
Sword of the Holy Flame. This thing looks insane.
Please give it to me.
Look at it. Chest. It looks insane.
Woo! I'm taking that! And apparently there's like also...
Doesn't it do like 250 damage?
Yeah, it does. I mean, it's for level 12s, so we're a little bit off from that. What are we now?
It just means your AP cost goes up, right?
By 3, though.
Yeah, it's a lot of damage, though.
It's only a 30% damage increase. For the 3 AP, I would rather use 2 moves in a round. It's good, though. Like, it's absolutely good.
Yeah, that'll be something to hold on to for later.
Oh, yeah, I'm looking forward to that.
Good thing we came down here.
Oh, yeah. See? Robbing the town.
Turns out the smithies smith things from time to time that are worth a look.
Oh, yeah. Apple, bread.
Let's take all the food. Mine now.
Now you will never leave, Wander. You will never leave this place, Wander. Dude, what are you doing right now? Are you just attacking everything in there?
Mabel, no fear.
What are you doing?
I don't really know. I was just like, you know what? I could destroy almost everything. Ooh, cloth scraps. That shit is rare. Alright, well, I'm done.
You live in... Aw.
Did you put an anvil in my...
Yeah. You just walk through it?
You can walk right around it. Actually, come to think of it, is there a grindstone in here? Because I can totally improve that sword. There is no grind wheel. What the hell?
You can use anvils for, wands?
You mean to tell me there's literally no grindstone in this entire smithy? What? Pardon me, but... What? Oh, hey. Treasure chest over here.
You crafted nothing.
Oh.
I don't necessarily know how crafting works. I just threw a wand on there and was like, let's craft this wand. It said, you crafted nothing. I'm like, okay, I don't know what happened.
Crafting is... a pain.
A wiki page.
yeah. Well, once you discover the recipe, it's not so bad, but you gotta figure it out first. Okay, well, I have destroyed that entire person's back room. Yeah, there's no grindstone in here. What the hell?
See, when I went in and out, it went in a way that was gonna not reveal our presence there.
Yeah, nobody notices.
Wow, if we started fighting this town, there'd be a lot of them.
Can we, like, at the end of the series, once we're done, murder everyone?
It's like this horrible epilogue. The goddess
breathes. Oh, this is a... not really. This is a hydrosophist, aerotherge, skill trainer. But she has Scrolls of Resurrection, which is... we are running severely low on. So I'm gonna let you do that. I'm gonna go look for more... You must
be a prize fighter. Let's bolt. One look at you,
and I'm knocked out. Ooh, invisibility.
I'm gonna look for things. Hey, soap.
Oh, nether swap. Make two characters switch places. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Amazing.
There are reasons why that would be handy. Wanna
have a good time? I found a hooker. Come hither, sweetheart. And possibly a gay hooker.
Delicious.
He called me a prize fighter. I was confused. I decided to leave. Half as dumb
and twice as mean. Congratulations.
Okay, let's see. Oh, Bear Daughter is still injured, isn't she?
Ooh.
Let's heal up. Okay. Got a chest.
Like an ice wall. My current spell is called Regeneration, so that's the other one's a new healing spell.
Oh, did you get a better healing spell?
I'm looking around. There's Water of Life.
Is it good?
You and allies around you magically gain constitution and heal immensely. Doesn't actually tell you how much it does.
That sounds worthwhile, though.
Yeah, it also cost me all my money.
I can send you more. How much do you need?
Also, tornado seems cool. How much money do you have, and what are you reacting to right now?
I've got 8,000. There's an explosive skeleton in the upstairs here.
Please, somebody do something.
I currently have like 1,000. Should I be teleporting to you right now?
Probably, yeah. I'm gonna quick save before this does anything. And I'm gonna switch to Bear Daughter.
That's an interesting room they've got in there.
Thank you.
Can you heal her before she burns to death?
My life.
What did he say?
Of Frederick that did this to me. He locked me in here with that ridiculous creature.
You might also want to put a. No, so she's dying, but since she's in dialogue, she won't take damage. But apparently some dude named Frederick put a sentient bomb in this room with her. You might want to make it rain, too. She might die. I don't know if... Nope. She's immune to fire while talking to people. Apparently dialogue makes you invincible.
That was a really weird interaction right there. I think the game's co-op broke again.
Yeah, just a little bit.
I think you were supposed to talk to her and then try to solve the problem.
Yeah, what we were supposed to do is... Yeah, I think what happened was since Bear Daughter wasn't involved in the dialogue, since I was going to use her to open the door and hit it with an ice arrow, it drags my character into dialogue. Bear Daughter keeps going, opens the door, Bicky Bomb blows up, and then you save the day.
Very confusing. They didn't really... Honestly, not very well implemented.
Nope.
it's kind of a mess.
We solved it. I mean, it's not like a main plot thing, so who cares, really? But still...
Dear me, I need to get out of this room. Yes, I'll go downstairs to catch a breath of fresh air. But do come and talk to me again if you want to hear more about what transpired here. My thanks once more, sweet hero.
Well, let's see. Well, and she also sells soap. Well, we got it.
Yay, reputation. Yeah. We saved people, and this chest didn't explode. Good news. Right.
As far as I can tell, there is nobody up here.
Not really.
Well. I'm gonna go see what I can loot.
Oh yeah, I guess this is technically stealing. Oh well.
I mean, do we care that much? No.
Eh.